Honorable the Chief Justice of India, Ambassador Ashok Kumar Mukherjee, Mr. M.K. Raina, Mr. Siddharth Vardarajan, Priya, Sweta, Minnie, and other members of the Hingurani family, distinguished author Aman Hingurani, good evening to all of you. I can see very large number of very distinguished members in the audience. I wish to convey my greetings to all of them. Aman is the right person to tell us how we can have perpetual aman or peace in the Kashmir region. What he has done seems to be most difficult task for most of us. As Norman Mailer, a distinguished writer, has mentioned, a book is closest man ever come to childbearing. It's so difficult, and he has spent, I was told, more than about 10 years on writing this book. The other day when Priya called in The Hague and asked me to be present in the book release function, I readily agreed for two reasons. One, to congratulate Aman, for whom I have a lot of affection, and to utilize this opportunity to convey my condolences and my respect for Mrs. and Mr. Hingurani, a very special couple. I had very close association with both of them when Aman was a school-going child. From that time I had known the family. She has made tremendous contribution in the development of law and jurisprudence. In 1979, she filed a petition in the Supreme Court that was the beginning of public interest litigation regarding under-trial prisoners, and by that petition alone, thousands of prisoners who were languishing in jail were released. At that time, I was also involved in public interest litigation, that is Agra Protective Home. A petition was filed by two very distinguished members of Indian academic world, Dr. Upendra Bakshi and Lothika Sarkar, about the inhuman condition in Agra Protective Home. By judicial direction and by the approach of the state of UP, not only the conditions in Agra Protective Home were improved, but all the homes in the state of UP were improved by that. That was the beginning of public interest litigation, and the entire jurisprudence of public interest litigation started from that point. And Mr. Nirmal Hingurani and Ms. Kapila Hingurani played significant role in those days. I convey my tribute to them for their contribution. And all this was done pro bono at the cost of their otherwise lucrative practice. I'm happy that Aman is following the worthy footsteps of his parents, and apart from practicing law and acting as a mediator, he is spending sufficient time for writing books and teaching to the students. Aman's work has been an addition to the vast literature we have on Kashmir problem. Some of the most eminent authors are in the audience. Dr. Karan Singh has made great contribution. Former governor, Sri Jagmohan Ji, has made great contribution. Our former Chief Justice Anand has made great contribution. Now, Aman is in the category of those eminent and distinguished writers. I hope this is not going to be the last book from him. He'll continue with his interest and make further great contribution in this field. The first chapter of the book deals with subcontinent under the British colonial rule. And by his extensive empirical research, he has given some facts which were not known to me, at least, but I'm sure they were lesser known. Particularly, he talks about the unity among Hindus and Muslims. He referred to a public speech by Sayyid Ahmed Khan in Gurdaspur on 27 January 1884, in which he said, Hindus and Muslims should try to become one heart and soul and act as union. Religion is only for personal use, but we all belong to one nation. That was said in 1884. How relevant it is even now today. According to Aman's research, Britishers have created differences and rift between Hindus and Muslims by they propounded a theory of divide and rule and perpetuated that. Aman's research has brought out very significant fact that a person who was responsible for Indian partition, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, he entered the politics in 1906 as secretary of Dada Bhai Naroji and then became devoted disciple of Gopal Krishna Gokhale and with whom he had gone to United Kingdom in 1913. The credentials of Muhammad Ali Jinnah was so impressive that Sarojini Naidu, who became the first president of Congress Party in 1915, gave title to Jinnah as ambassador of Hindu and Muslims. Now, these are some of the facts which has been brought in Aman's book, which I, at least I was not aware of it fully. He has done deep research and empirical surveys have revealed some of the very fresh material which I have found in this book. And my former colleague, Justice Uma Pal, has aptly observed that book is fascinating and compelling reading. Aman has suggested some solution of the problem, including approaching the International Court of Justice. I would refrain to make any comment as far as that chapter is concerned because of my peculiar position. But he has given innovative thought to it, and he ultimately comes to the conclusion that ultimately the problems has to be solved by mutual dialogue. Both countries have to learn to live with each other. Neighbors are not a matter of choice, but in the larger interest, they have to find solution of their own problems. Book clearly reflects that it's written by a lawyer, because he has dealt legal and constitutional aspect of the Kashmir problem extensively. He has devoted a full chapter on approaching the International Court of Justice and what should be the stand. This is a great effort which has been put in by Aman, and I congratulate him for bringing out such a fascinating, thought-provoking and fine book. I hope that in future he would keep the academic side of the profession alive and continue to make great contribution. Thank you so much.